Welcome to Kids Workshop. And as you know, you should know by now, we are building this boat. And we are, first we made this part, put these in. And the boat is made of two half, and we have the other half here. So, and the first, where do I have that? I have here. Put this over here. And you can see we are, the first thing we did was to put this around, that is this piece here, and then we have to put these smaller sticks on here. So, and the first part of them, that is pretty easy, just on with it and then glue it and a needle in, but you'll see that in a moment. And where do I have these? I have them here. I think yes. I have put the fittings I have put in here so they don't get dirty. And destroyed. But you can see the back part here. We put this in later on, and then we sand it so it get, because otherwise it will get too difficult to get around that corner. But this is not that difficult as it looks. It just takes a lot of time because it has to dry in between. You can put new sticks on. You can put two or three or maybe four on, but then you have to let it dry a little before you can see. I have some tape here to help hold it. And a scalpel is a good thing to have, hobby knife or something like that, because so. And then we have this one. So, and you can see the reason it is on this board here, that follow, this is included in the package. It is, you can imagine, when you put a lot of, what the name for that, but when you put a lot of these sticks on, then it had a tendency to bend, because you kind of drag it in the wrong way, so you have to fasten it to this board, but as you can see, I have just done it with a couple of needles. That's all. That's enough. And it also easier to handle and when you're doing it. But now we will remove some of these and hope the glue is dry enough so that and it's a good thing to have something to stick the needle in, because if they are difficult to get a hold on otherwise. So find something. Maybe your mother have something she have her needles in. Maybe you can borrow that. This is a block of model clay. So because when you are gluing these sticks, we call them list. I don't know what you're calling them. I should have looked that up before we started, but I forgot. Because when you get that one was bent, you don't want to use that anymore. Oop. Always good to kind of be prepared when you're doing this, have the needles ready and have you can see here I have put some tape on the table here, and I have cut it like this so I can do like this, and then I have these small strips I can. Because you, when you have put the glue on, you have to get it finished before the glue is dried. So it's always good to have all the things you need at hand. There's a needle. And the last one. So, but one thing is that you can see the distance from here to there is longer than the distance from here to there. So you need to kind of get them to fit. I don't know if you can see here. See, this one I have cut, I have made so it does like this. So you kind of have to get it to fit. And, but it kind of now I cannot figure out the word. It kind of obvious when you are looking at it, where to cut it and where not to cut it. Now, even I have try to clean the glue up when I put it there. Where I put too much glue on, I try to remove it while it's wet, but still and afterward we have to sand it so it gets, when we are all finished with it, we sand it so it gets smooth and fine, and then we have to put some sparkle in here to kind of before we paint it. But that's we get to later. You see, now I have cut this, and I do it with this one here, with the sandpaper that's rotating. But you can, what I would suggest you do, if you don't have a thing like that, this one we have used to other projects. You have glued sandpaper on here, and then you can sand it to the so it fits. And take your time. It's very important, because the better you make it fit, the lesser problem you have. Where did I think it was here. No, or was it here? Yes. So, and then now I just this needle is just so I can see. Where I want to have it. Yes. Because, sorry, I made a mark before. You can see the little mark. And then And the reason for this is if you, it gets harder and harder to, you break the stick more and more. So it's best to do it like this. And then you saw the first time we used this glue that was included in the package, but this is nearly only water, so I use my own glue. It's a white carpenter glue, so not worth using that stuff there. And it was here, and from this one and to this one. And maybe I should make a little mark to here. And to here, right? And then I put glue on the edge here. Or maybe I should have drawn it here before. Well, and then I use this. And glued, I guess you don't have to be afraid to put too much on, because you can clean it off afterwards. It's just so better to be sure you have a good And you can see here, you cannot put a needle in here. And so what I do is I take one of my, these ones here. It's, we call it painter tapes. Here you can put a needle in this part. So, and here we need some painter's tape again. And then it's a good thing I have some ready. And then just to hold it in place. So and then my beloved cotton sticks. Just the worst, we are sanding it afterwards. The more important part is down here. So, because when you need the new stick to get up there, you don't want to have it laying on a bump, a glue bump. So, and now we can take a whole one from from PUBG. No, I want to, I don't know if you can see it, but here there is a kind of a sharp turn, so here I want to put one little one over, so I get a kind of a smooth line from here to the front. So we will do that. But and I take one of these I have left. From all the sticks are longer than the boat, so. And you don't want breaks like this, so. You want one like this over here, so. We will. See, then you even the and now you want to make it a little longer. Yes. And when I mean the reason why I want it to be a little longer is so it can lay on this one here. And then I make a mark here and here, we say, and the highest point is here, kind of, right? A mark there. I should have done it on the other side, but I do that now. See, like this, like this. So, because now it's the other way around. We'll get rid of this piece, and then. And this is 240 grit sandpaper that's on there. So, because these here are very soft. Can you see? Now it kind of getting. Then now you have a smoother line, right? Maybe like this. Maybe I should turn it around. Ripty. Yes, that was the right way. So, you can see when I get it on here. You see the line it. But what you are doing will maybe be in another way. This, there is not only one way to do this. It's kind of how it goes for you when you are doing this. From there to there. Are you getting? Yes. Yes. Your mileage can vary, or something like that. And that's the fun thing, building stuff like this, when you are building a plastic set, then there is only one way to do stuff. So, yeah. Get away. I cannot get room here. Yeah. Up. That was not the plan. Up. I see. Here we have the same problem. We need a little piece of tape to keep it down. Okay, use this one. Ah. And we will, sorry, have I remembered to record? I have. That's the biggest problem when you get to this part. It's just kind of tilts all the time. There's not so much glue on this tape, but it's not necessary. This one went wrong. So, and our cotton stick. See, as soon as I do it in one end, The reason I didn't do it this way was because now I cannot put the next one on right away. That's irritating. But because we don't want to wait so long. But you can see now it's more smooth line. So next time I can put this one on, but I cannot do now because of the needles in the way. But now it kind of works this way here. I have to bend it a little, but not that much. But now I cannot. Because of the needle. So, but we can start to do something here in the back. Can you see anything here? Yes. Because we are down here, and this way, like this, maybe this way was better. Need to get some of the glue away. So that we can get it right up against. Why? As close as we can get it. Okay. We will use this one. This is balsa wood, so it's very wide. And it That was better. We don't want too big a gap. So, I'm going to give that a little something something here. Take one more. Yes. And then you will take one of these. The one with the here, just so that we then just a little pressure to the start. The good thing about this, see, I put one on this side and one look that side. But the good thing with this glue is that it kind of snaps reasonably fast. And then we have to lay a rail on there. Lay it on. This way, because we need a stick down here in a little while. So, and shall we try and remove that one and that one? We'll start down here then. Oops. Up. This one fall off. Oops, this is not the right one. Go away. This is the right one. The reason we have all this trouble is because I try to do stuff quicker than it's possible. And that's not a good idea. See, kind of. So, shall we try to remove that one? Nothing happened. So we are good. Maybe we should use our porcupine to that. Did I? Who took my tools? Here it is. So, and so, yes. Maybe I should do like this. See anything? Yes. This end. So see, like this, and then I'll do like this, so I kind of make it a little flatter in the end here. So, then now I have, its angle is this way, and it kind of flat this way. So I get it close to the where it's gonna lay. And now this is not gonna be the correct place anymore. They are a little nasty to stick in with their fingers. So, shall we try? one there. And this one. And now when we put a stick on here, then it helps to hold. So, and then we will approve this way. Maybe I should get it in the bowl part. Necessary. So. It's a little easier in a syringe than to move around with a big one. Need one down here too. So, and it's a little sharp here in the corner. So. You can see here it's kind of hard to get out. Let us hope we can do it. Now I've been. Oof. That needle are not any good anymore. Bend it. It's kind of hot. You can see it's a very tight bend, this one. But, don't do it. Now it get kind of hard. around the corner here. Yeah, the reason I have the problem with the, whoops, the pliers have kind of teeth in here, but when you, the needle just get up when I pressure. It just, so. Now I have to, I cannot see anything else. You can see it kind of get, I don't like it. Because it both turn in the one direction and then in the other. So, and the last one. So, see, but it's kind of, I think we have to make one so kind of, because it turned this way and it turned this way out here, so it's a little difficult. Difficult, but not impossible. Oh. And if you don't do this, then you cannot get them tied up against that, or you have to cut it later on. I will remove my sweater. I think we need something here that can, it is, you can see it's kind of a wild, turn around here. Oop. Thank you. Let me see how far that gets us. From here, maybe from here. Up. From here. To here, right? See what that gave us. Turn this way. It was better. And then make a mark, kind of someplace there and someplace there. So but you can see, now we are nearly used an hour, and how far have we gotten? It's not because it's that difficult, but it's time consuming. See? Yes. There to the, to where to there. Right. And regardless if you build all the time because of all the breaks in between, it will take at least a week to build one of these. Because as you have seen, you cannot keep on and keep on and keep on, because it has to dry. And It's something you have to enjoy while you while you are doing it. Now I have kind of put myself out of work again because I put these down that way. Two, that's too much. And one in here. See? And then we need something to hold it here. Some tape. So, but we somehow we needed to get the bend the other way because it will end so down here anyway. But we will get there sooner or later, and it will be great. It will look very nice. And we are finished, I promise. But now we have used an hour. And before you get tired of this, I will stop and say thanks for today. And hope I'll see you next Tuesday. And we will, I will do something in between, but as you can see, I will not get finished because I have other things I have to do. So, but thank you for viewing, and see you next Tuesday. Bye bye.